The opportunity tonight to get a very unique perspective on urban nights from the seat of your bike this time. And joining us to talk about it is Andy Williamson. So welcome Andy.
Thanks for coming on.
I'm excited to be here.
Yeah, so I mean, let's get right into it. You've got this really awesome bike here. So what can people do exactly with the bikes tonight?
Yeah, so Urban Bikes is basically a big fun bike parade, yeah. Celebrating bike culture.
A bike parade.
Yeah, yeah. It's family friendly. Not really recommended for really little kids, but a lot of little kids are in trailers or on the back of their parents' bike. The Dayton Police Department is great to be there to support us in closing the streets. We ride around town. We highlight some of the great areas of urban nights, mm-hmm. including Wright Dunbar, Oregon District, and of course we end up right here at the end to get people to get the information and kick it off.
Great.
So how long approximately when people are taking the tour around urban nights, how long does it take?
It's about 30 to 45 minutes, so it's a pretty short ride. It's a little slower than if you're maybe out riding by yourself, but it's pretty casual, pretty slow paced.
So it's nothing strenuous,
nothing.
Don't
even break a sweat.
You don't have to be an expert mountain biker to do it.
And we want to be clear, you're not renting bikes, so people need to bring their bikes.
Yeah, bring your own bike, find a place to park. We meet over at the Don Crawford Plaza over at the Fifth Third Ballpark.
Great. And what time will that tour be sort of heading out?
Yeah, we'll be leaving at 6 p.m. And Bike Miami Valley, the local nonprofit advocacy organization working with community leaders on making the entire community more bike friendly, is heading this up. You can see the t-shirt. And we're excited to have everybody come out. Weather's perfect. It's an awesome day to go for a ride.
Yeah, the weather is definitely gorgeous. And you talked really briefly about it. Talk a little bit more in depth about Bike Miami Valley.
Yeah, Bike Miami Valley historically has been around since the 70s. They actually were formed to help build this amazing bikeway network we have here in the region. We have 330 miles. We have one of the largest bikeway networks or paved multi-use paths in the entire country. A lot of people don't realize that.
Wow.
But as that's now been built, we don't need to focus on bikeways. We're focusing on activities and educational programs, encourage people to get out and ride their bikes for transportation, not just recreation, and of course working with the city to move their efforts forward with the bike lanes and all the other great projects, and the new bike racks are going to be popping up all over town too.
Yes.
We're excited about that.
So that's great. There are many more opportunities more than just tonight. Now how many people are you expecting to come out for this?
Well, our largest event we've had with weather like this was almost 300 people, so we're hoping that we'll have the same crowd.
300 people all on a bike, touring around urban nights, downtown area.
And
that's
with this
fun.
Weather, it needs to happen, you guys. Make sure you come out. There's no excuse not to hop on the bikes. Bring the family. And one more time, what time are you guys meeting tonight?
6 p.m., Don Crawford Plaza, Fifth Third Field.
Great. Wonderful. Thank you so much, Andy.
Thank you very much. But stay tuned. Still to come on the show, Jim Bucher gives us updates from the Cannery Art and Design Center. Get the news on their new location and their name change.